Hello there, we're back again using the Blitzer introductory and intermediate algebra combo text as a guideline for beginning algebra. My name is Professor Shannon Gracie, and here we go. This section covers the multiplication property of equality. So, what we're going to be learning about today is how we would use the multiplication property to solve equations in the form of the opposite of x or negative x is equal to c, and use the addition and multiplication properties to solve equations simultaneously. And we'll actually get a preview of that in one or two of the warm-up problems. And then we'll be working on solving applied problems using formulas. Already, go ahead and give the warm-up a shot. It might be a little bit above your pay grade, but you can try it out, and I'll work on it in a moment. All right, let's see how you guys did. So for this one, let's go ahead and if we were to, let's go ahead and take care of the variable component. So if we were to subtract 1z from both sides of the equation, we would end up getting 4z minus 12 equals 0z plus 8. This leaves us with 4z minus 12 is equal to 0 plus 8. And not everybody's going to need to write all these steps. But just in the interest of being thorough, here we are. So far we've got 4z's minus 12 is 8. So now what we need to do is we need to isolate the variable term. So in order to do that, let me rewrite that top line so that we've got a fresh area. If we were to add 12 to both sides, we would end up getting 4z plus 0 is equal to 20. This, of course, gives us 4z is equal to 20. Now, we don't want to know what 4z is equal to. We want to know what 1z is equal to. So, what we'll need to do is multiply by the number on both sides because we have to balance everything out, which will give us a result of 1z. So here, do you see that 1/4 times 4 gives us a result of 1z, and 20 times 1/4 is going to give us a result of 5, and this gives us a result of z equals 5. So in our roster notation, that is our solution. How'd you guys do? Awesome. All right. Here we go. Next up, let me put a little line here. So we've got a little work to do. I'm eyeballing this part right here. So let's go ahead and clean that up a bit. Remember, this is going to be negative 7 times 2 minus negative 7 times x, and that plus 18 will go along for the ride. So the yellow highlighting is equivalent. So then we'll have x is equal to negative 14 plus 7x's plus 18. We can combine the negative 14 and the 18 to get us a result of x is equal to 7x's plus 4. Now, what we need to do is we need to get these x's together. So again, let's go up here a bit. And I'll rewrite this. So now it's up to you. Actually, I think it might be easier if we subtracted 1x from both sides. Okay, so on this side we'll have 0 x's is equal to 6 x's plus 4, which of course is 0 equals 6 x plus 4. And if we now subtract 4 from both sides, 0 minus 4 gives us negative 4, and negative 4 will be equal to 6 x's. And again, we have to use a similar technique. If we multiply both sides of this by 1/6, that's going to give us a 1 in front of the x. Remember that the we can multiply these in any order. It doesn't require the distributive law. There's just three factors being multiplied together. So here, this one is going to reduce to be negative 2/3 is equal to 1x, which gives us negative 2/3 is equal to x, and in our roster notation, we'll put our negative 2/3. Whoops, that one looks a little crazy. And that's our end. That's our end result. All right, so here we go. How'd you do anyway? Did you get those? If you did, that is so awesome, because this is exactly what we're learning today, is how to use the multiplication property of equality to solve linear equations in one variable. So here we go. The multiplication property of equality. The same non-zero real number or algebraic expression may multiply both sides. Of an equation without changing the solution. That is, let's scroll down a bit, if A is equal to B, and we don't want C to be 0 this time, then A times C is equal to B times C. So here we go. Now these you're probably actually going to find easier than the warm-up. Right. So with the first guy, actually I'm going to set you guys loose on these. And why don't you give, there are six problems. I'd like you to give them a shot. If you don't struggle and get frustrated, you know, and not always be just copying things, then if you don't do that, you're not going to learn. So go ahead, pause the movie, work these problems, and then I'll work them for you. On your mark, get set, go. Okay, we're back. Let's see how you guys did. So in the first problem, the variable is z, and we've got a coefficient of negative 5. So the multiplicative inverse for negative 5 is negative 1/5. That is the number that when you multiply it to negative 5, you get a result of 1. So we'll get 1z is equal to, so we have a two negatives, so that'll be positive, and it'll be a positive 4. And so then z is going to be equal to 4, and in our roster notation, we put down 4. Okay. I'll go ahead and do this one since it's on the same page. We've got a negative 1/8 times x. So in order to get a result of 1 in front of the x, we're going to need to multiply both sides by negative 8. So this will give us a result of 1x is equal to negative 48, which of course means that x is negative 48. And that's what we put in our roster notation. How you doing so far? Awesome. Okay. What do you think's going on with number two? What's our variable? Yes, our variable is y, and we have negative 1y. But we want it to be a positive 1y. So what can we do? Good. We can multiply it by negative 1, both sides by negative 1. That gives us positive 51 is equal to 1y. That's the same thing, whoops, as 51 being equal to y. So our answer is 51. All right, so for number three, we need to combine the like terms, meaning the 8x and the negative 3x. So when we combine those, we'll get 5x's equals negative 45. And we need to get a 1 in front of the x, so we multiply both sides by 1/5. We get 1x is equal to negative 9, so x is negative 9. And we get our result here. All right, going over to number five. Now we're going to step up the game a little bit. I've been separately getting the constants and the variable terms together, but you can actually, add or subtract a whole algebraic expression. So here we go. I'm looking at number five. I want to get the z's on the left side. Okay, I want z to be on the left side. And I want the constants to be on the right side. So if I subtract z from both sides, and then, so did you see how that would get the z's to the left? And if I add 3 to both sides, that'll get the constants on the right. Okay. So this is just kind of multitasking. If you have issues with doing it this way, go back to doing it one at a time. 6z minus 1z is 5z's. Negative 3 plus 3 is 0. Over here, z minus z is 0z's. And 2 plus 3 is 5. 5z plus 0 is just 5z. Remember, 0z's is the same as 0. So we get 5z is 5. And again, the number that's going to work is multiplying both sides by 1/5. So this gives us 1z is 1, and our z equals 1. So in our roster notation, we get our answer of 1. That is our solution. And number 6. I'm going to use that same skill because it saves so much time if you can get used to it. I want the y's on the left side of the equation, and I want the constants on the right. So I'm going to subtract 3y from both sides, and I will subtract 6 from both sides. All right, so we end up with 2y's plus 0 is equal to 0y's. Be careful, minus 12. A lot of times people get the urge to put 0 there. Remember, it's negative 6 decreased by 6 is negative 12. So this gives us 2y is 0 minus 12. 2y is negative 12. We want 1y, not 2y's. So we'll be multiplying both sides by the reciprocal of 2, which is a half. This gives us a result of 1y is equal to negative 6. Y equals negative 6. And wrap it up in our roster notation, and we're good to go. Okay, so next up, Got a little application for you. I always like this one. It's about lightning. So the formula M equals N divided by 5 models your distance M from a lightning strike in a thunderstorm if it takes N seconds to hear thunder after seeing the lightning. If you are 3 miles away from the lightning flash, how long will it take the sound of thunder to reach you? So go ahead and pause the movie and try to work this one out on your own. See how you do. Okay, let's see how you did. Now, we had our model of M was equal to N over 5. That was our formula. Now, here, this is saying that we are 3 miles away from the lightning flash. So, 3 miles away means that we are going to N stood for seconds. Okay, so the distance has to be M. All right, your distance from the lightning strike. So that's going to be our M. Right? So we will get 3 is equal to N over 5, plugging in 3 for M. Now to solve this, do you see that we need to multiply both sides by 5 in order to get a 1 in front of the N? So we will get 15 equals 1N. 15 equals N. So it will, now let's answer the question. The sound of thunder would reach me in 15 seconds. So the trick is you just look at the last item, or near the last item, you're answering the question, right? How long will it take the sound of thunder to reach you? Oh, it'll take the sound of thunder to reach me 15 seconds. All right, so just remember you're answering the question, and you often get that in the very last statement or the last question of the problem. All right, so this actually 2.2 was a short one. So this wraps up 2.2, and we'll be heading into section 2.3 whenever you're ready, whenever you.